Welcome to the Short Book Summaries channel. Enjoy and subscribe if you like our work. Do you hunger for skills to improve the quality of your relationships, to deepen your sense of personal empowerment, or to simply communicate more effectively? Unfortunately, for centuries our culture has taught us to think and speak in ways that can actually perpetuate conflict, internal pain, and even violence. Nonviolent Communication partners practical skills with a powerful consciousness and vocabulary to help you get what you want peacefully. In this internationally acclaimed text, Marshall Rosenberg offers insightful stories, anecdotes, practical exercises, and role plays that will dramatically change your approach to communication for the better. Discover how the language you use can strengthen your relationships, build trust, prevent conflicts, and heal pain. Revolutionary, yet simple, NVC offers you the most effective tools to reduce violence and create peace in your life, one interaction at a time. Over 150,000 copies sold and now available in 20 languages around the world. More than 250,000 people each year from all walks of life are learning these life-changing skills. Essential reading, even if I am like 2 decades too late to reading this. I've already started using it, and though I probably sound like a moron, I'm confident I'll get better at talking through my needs. Everyone just wants to be loved, and we just keep asking for it the wrong way. The best book I've read about communication, interpersonal relationships, and resolving conflicts. I have a strong feeling that this will be the best I've ever read about the subjects. A brilliant handbook for how to talk to people without judging them, alienating them, or really pissing them off. The book is enlivened with a number of transcripts of conversations in which the author and his acquaintances get it right sometimes and fail at other times. The basic idea will be familiar to anyone who has had a little therapy or knows a therapist. You talk about your feelings, not what the other person is doing wrong. Of course, that is difficult to do under the best of circumstances, and well nigh impossible when everyone present is stressed out or furious or violent. But with lots of practice, you can get better at the art of communication and learn to avoid saying things like, "Why did you do that? That's really stupid."